next presenter, Professor Srinivasan Sundarrajan, Director, National Institute of Technology, Tiruchirappalli.
The expertise available at NIT Trichy, which is actually a 50-year-old, we've got about 15 departments with multiple specialities. I just would like to outline how we are going about dealing with the DRDO. Basically, I'm also from DRDO and then been working with other industries and services. Why I'm focusing more on this is it would be helpful for the institutions who would like to get into this defense research forum. The expertise available in the institution is multiple. When I took over, we have got a number of ARNB projects and NRB projects and various fronts. But the question is, first decision we took was we'll align ourselves to DRDO requirements, defense requirements. When that decision has been taken, similar to what we had discussion in the morning, the faculty everywhere, they know every department is different departments. It's they are all islands, and faculty have got their own expertise. So the basic question everybody is asking DRDO today is, you know, I'm having this expertise. What is the problem you are having? Why can't you marry these two things? It's very, very difficult. See, DRDO issues are many. The basic input has to come from the academic institution. So first decision was, okay, we'll align to the DRDO or defense requirement. Second, there are many people are working on the similar areas, no? So we have to work on the niche areas. Where others are not working, we'll work. That's the second decision. Third, it has to be industry oriented, because now the higher education, all IITs, NITs and other institutions, as per Kakorka committee, it is essential for us to get into industry-oriented research. DRDO is industry for us, because the multiple industries which they are dealing with, is there the industry. So whether we like it or not, in any institution, we have to essentially align with ourselves to the DRDO or industry requirement. So with this, the first step was to identify the areas in which we are working. One area is, morning I was mentioning about electronic packaging, because electronic packaging is one area where DRDO is looking for, there is a civilian application, so that's a place where there is a lot of business. But electronic packaging per se, no institute in the country is working. So we took as electronic packaging of one. Okay, then we build a network with the other universities, University of UAS, University of Georgia Tech, and then try to correlate, gather the information from other places, start running the courses. By the time when we are starting the courses, we are aware of ourselves about how to go about it. That's where the second step has come in. The second step for us was to conduct the training program for the DRDO, missile scientists. Our people cannot enter DRDO. And also the missile scientists cannot spare time to come to our place at a regular working day. So since we have converted our rooms into our classroom to virtual mode, we started interacting with the missile scientists on a virtual mode. The training, we started training a certification program, NIT certification program, and they had to write the examination. So 30 odd scientists in materials, manufacturing, different topics. We took control and guidance. We took the video training. The advantage is the faculty, when they are training the scientists, scientists are keen on learning the subject. At the same time, there is a fact that scientists who have joined DRDO and spent about 2-3 years or 4 years, they know the subject, upright subject, much better than the faculty, because they have been working on a particular area. And they are working in the areas where they can fund. Actually, DRDO is the type of interaction is actually a treasure. Because once you know the one-to-one contact with the scientists here, then the faculty gets into contact, faculty automatically gets into the problem, he takes some time, afterwards he becomes a specialist, then he becomes a review member in DRDO. So this is the second step we took by conducting the training program for the DRDO scientists. The third one is the identification of the core areas. Like, you know, one area is corrosion, surface engineering. This is one area which is again tremendous potential both in DRDO as well as in other industries. So we have set up a center of excellence. The center of excellence, the first deviation was there, that is, if it is an independent department for us, it is very difficult to get into a focused objective. I say all the 15 departments, right from mathematics to management, from every department we have formed the task team and then identified as a task team, special task team. The surface engineering, second on electronic packaging, third on safety, the fourth on NDE, fifth on welding. Like this 15 centers, 15 task teams we have formed, and we have not approached DRDO for that. So we have started, and then the faculty who have been doing with the conversion with the R&DP project, and they are conversing with other areas, they've all joined together, and for them, again, the homework has to be from the web page of the individual laboratory, 52 laboratories, they got the speciality. The issues are all well listed in the DRDO website. Once we are into that, that's where for anybody to interact with each other, there has to be some base for us. So we have come to that base where we have set up our task force on various aspects of DRDO, the issues of services, which is also having commercial application, because we had to play a major role. We have identified what we can play a major role with the industries. When you are talking about DRDO, when you are talking about industries, we are coming in between. When we talk about the Air Force indigenization program, the quantity is very less, quality is very high. So the industry to focus on that with a PhD, with all the qualification, is just not possible. They just don't bother, even though they know it produces a lot of value. So what we are doing is to bring the SME sector, identify the indigenization products, and then take it as a project, involve the students who are all, you know, top 1,000 rankers are joining our institute, students, along with the students, the concerned faculty, and make the SME cluster to join with us. The SME cluster will automatically will join with the Air Force or Navy or Army at a later date, but in between, we operate as an in-between agency. Similarly, offset policy of defense, 20%, 40% has to be developed within the country. If it is a critical, it is minimum 20%, or 40% is not critical. So the countries like US and all, Russians are very good, very, very close. Israelis are very close. Countries like French, English, and American, they are not all that, they don't believe much in this industry. So we operate on university-to-university contact with these countries. We are having tie-up with number of industries over here, about 200-300 industries. They are having tie-up with their industries. Again, we are operating in between as a joining, university-to-university contact. Their industry will believe their university, our industry will believe our university, then it leads to industry-to-industry contact later. This is another strategy we are following. We are also setting up, in between we have started our own company, NIT company we have inaugurated, and then the innovative projects will be commercialized by the incubation company. We have also now, from 2015 onwards, we are getting the research part. So every industry, the industry's product, DRDO support, and then other support, it goes to a center within the campus for production. Why I'm telling this is the journey is very difficult. Entry into any of the service requirement or DRDO requirement is not all that easy. It is not somebody sitting here to give the projects to all the universities as per capability or capacity the university is having. It is, we have to nurture ourselves towards the DRDO capability, DRDO requirement, and then it becomes a big group. This is where the information, communication, indigenization, everything will have to have a win-win partnership. We are also opened up, reduced our PhD requirement, because independently we can have our own Senate. We have passed a win-win situation, so where DRDO scientists can get a MS degree or a PhD degree without that one semester requirement. Means a one semester requirement, we have eased it up to 8 weeks requirement spread over 3 years. That's where, unless both are attracted, the project will not succeed. So this, with this background for the last 3 years, now we are approaching DRDO for the major program. That's where we are also, the 2-3 areas where we can work. One area is we are setting up the welding institute, the number one in the world. We are trying to set up the structural integrity center. The structural integrity center will do the complete, it will have the both national and international projects on welding, NDE, failure analysis, fracture toughness, computer simulation, everything put together. And then with this, for us to set up this, we need an interest, we need DRDO, we need DST, we need shipyards, we need the public sector, we need the services. So this is the MHRD. For attracting this, we need to have our own basic setup in our institution. MHRD has invested about 80 crores on characterization equipment. And we have set up this mostly for the requirements of DRDO. So this is the model in which we are working, where we can help others. Is, as Mani suggested, we can cluster our activities. We can cluster our activities, and we can help different, we can identify the areas where we can come together within ourselves, and then go to DRDO for a major program. Do it in a small way, for the literature side, for the student side, and then move to the very, very high level. In fact, warning, the professors who are all, professors have got a lot of advantages here. And Professor Ghoshal et al. Today, about 20 years back, he was a professor. But today, he is a highly respected man in the missile area. So that's, I thought, it's the 10 minutes I can share, remaining things. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you for sharing your experience.